Hello everyone, this is MD Varshit Khan. I am back in WBCS for all. As per my promise, now today I will start how to prepare economy from Ramesh Singh. Now today I will give you a demo lesson on chapter 1, introduction of economies. You can have a little bit of knowledge about me, that is I scored rank 8 in CTO 2016 and whatever I on the post I am working. Apart from that, you can get the detail of our face group, that is you can get a WBCS for all, and you can also join our YouTube channel. You can subscribe the channel WBCS for all and forward it to your friend so that they will get an easy access of information and they don't need to go to coaching center for every minor details. Okay, now one more request from you, and I want to congratulate each of you that I have seen that the response which I am getting from YouTube is overwhelmed, and I am very happy that I am able to contribute little bit to you in your education. Now let's begin the first chapter of Indian economy. Okay, now what are the types of economy on the basis of transaction? There are two types of economy. The first one is open economy, the second one is closed economy. Open economy are those economies which done transaction to outside of the world. Okay, means there are little bit of import and export, they are can be called open economies. And closed economies are those economy who do not done any type of economic transaction. They do not import anything, they do not export anything, but literally we can see there is no country in the world which is closed economy right now, because we are more or less we are dependent on each other. Okay, but right now in the present context we can say that North Korea is not an ideal example, but can be example of closed economy. China prior to 1985 was a closed economy, but right now there are no more closed economies. Okay, now, what is a capitalistic economy? These are the few terms which always disturb the candidates a lot. What is capitalist? What is socialist? Okay, now let's begin. What is capitalistic economy? We can say the economy has its origin, okay, in the book of Adam Smith, that is Wealth of Nation in 1776. One argument that Adam Smith is also called as the father of economics, because he was the first person who proposed any idea about economics. Either the capitalistic economy or the wealth of nation is the basis of classical economics. What is classical economics? It is against any government regulation of commerce and industry. Means government can't regulate or interfere in commerce and industry. They are stressing that the division of labor, that is a specialization. One labor who is specialized in a particular field can be given work in that particular field also. Okay, now they also advocated the environment of laissez-faire, that is non-interference from government. Means government can't interfere in economic activities, government can't play any economic role. Government has a role, they have to maintain the law and order, not more than that. Government have to be a facilitator, not a regulator. Okay, now they have the belief that there is invisible hand of market force which will bring equilibrium for a welfare state, and the need means that which will bring equilibrium means at what price what thing to sold at where. Okay, and they believe that the to become any country a welfare state, the need of competition is there. Okay, USA after got independence followed this model, and Western Europe followed this model. We can see still USA and Western Europe are very much developed. Okay, they are also called as the private enterprise system or free enterprise system or market economy. Okay, they decide that they told that what to produce, how much to produce, at what price to produce is left to private enterprises. Government has no economic role. That was the crux behind the capitalist economy. Now let's move to the state economy or the socialist economy. Now the idea behind the state economy or socialist economy was propounded by Karl Marx, but the idea came after Russian Revolution in 1907 and got its ideal shape in People's Republic of China in 1949. It spread to Eastern Europe and Latin American countries. Now we can say now the first idea was capitalism, the second idea was socialism. The socialism or the state economies are two types. The first one is socialist economy, that is USSR version of the state economy, where they advocated collective ownership of means and product. Means we all are owner. Okay, we all are owner of the means of production, properties and asset, and state have to play a large role. state have to play a very large role. Okay, but in communist economy, that is pre-1985 China, Cuba, okay, they advocated that state ownership of all property. You can't have private property in China. If you want to purchase a flat, you will get the lease of the flat for 99 years, for 100 years, but you can't be the owner. Okay, the properties including land, labor, absolute power to state, means state is the only entity which can possess any property. Okay, they came as a reaction and just opposite of capitalism. Okay, now the decision of production and supply will be taken by state government. Now what will happen? There will be inefficiencies. Okay, because it is very difficult to move a large elephant like state, also called as centralized or centrally planned or non-capitalist economy. Socialists advocated that the capitalists are exploitative, and capitalists told that the socialist as state capitalism, where state is sole exploitator, means wo they are bolche ora bolte chaiche je tumi o chor ami o chor tumi 200 mile chori korchi ami state eka chori korchi, mane they both are criticizing each other. Okay, now the third one, that is the mixed economy, that is the main thing. And even you can say that in the present world there is no ideal capitalist economy or not ideal socialist economy. Every economy is more or less mixed economy. Why? The capitalism failed in 1929 because of economic depression. The biggest depression, because economic depression in the world came in 1929. Even I can cite a situation in Germany. It was told that if you want to burn coal, it is cheaper to burn the mark, that is the currency of the country, then to the coal. The general theory of employment, interest and money, these are the book written by John Maynard Keynes that question the limitation of market mechanism and invisible market force, and suggested strong government intervention in the economy. You can remember the capitalist advocated the laissez-faire, you don't interfere, government can't dare to interfere in the economic sphere. But they can say that the theory failed in 1929, and Keynes, who was the economist at that time, advocated that the government must interfere, strong government intervention, the market has failed. Okay, now he suggested that increase in government expenditure, government should increase its expenditure. Okay, if government is not doing any economic activity, then how can government increase its expenditure? That's why they told, Keynes told that government should increase its expenditure and government should also start play economic role. He also advocated discretionary fiscal policy to boost demand. He is of the belief that government alone can boost demand, since low demand are the reason of the depression. Okay, now they told what is the basic core philosophy of the mixed economy. Capitalist to assimilate the goal of the socialist economy, means follow your ideal but inculcate or imbibe the ideals of the socialist economy. Now you can say the mixed culture start coming. Okay, the public goods, public goods or the social sector like healthcare, education, social security, sanitation, minimum level of nutrition should be done by government sector. More than 50% government spending start. Now, earlier all these things were done by private sector. Now, government, if we start taking care of all these things, health, sanitation, social sector, which are also called as public goods or social sector, then what will happen? The 50% of economic expenditure will be done by the government alone, and it started in Europe. That's why we can say the public sector of Europe is also developed. If you visit to any of the government hospital, you won't feel it is a government hospital. Their behavior totally changed. And one thing you must remember, a private hospital, or you can say Apollo, don't have any motivation to start its operation in the ground, especially in the blocks where I am working. The only role, the only hospital, the only schools which were provided here is done by government only, because these are the public goods. You can't earn profit here, so you can't invest. That's why government should play the role of a facilitator of public goods. So government started spending on public goods. They are also called as public goods or social goods, and that is why it is also called as a mixed economy. And remember the role which Keynes plays for the capitalist country to advocate the ideals of the socialist economy, the same role was placed by Oscar Lange. He was the Keynes of the socialist. He suggested the same thing for this socialist economy, that is the market capitalism. Okay, means market should be the main capital, market capitalism should be there, but government intervention should be there. Means where you can earn profit, where there is a hope of competition, you allow private sector, you allow market, but where there is no motivation for private sector, there is no motivation for you can say profit, the government should play the role, like health, sanitation, education, working in villages, minimum level of nutrition, etc. China adopted the communism under Mao Tse-tung, that is the total control of state in 1956, but in 1985 China realized its mistake. China announced its open door policy, the first experiment of market capitalism, and Lange suggested earlier also. So Lange had the last love, and you can say that the China is a blend example of mixed economy. Earlier it was totally communist regime, but we can say that it is developing very fast. Okay, now let's move to the next topic. The next topic is, what are the sectors of economy? They were the type of economy, socialist, capitalist and mixed economy. What are the sectors of economy? Sometimes question asked in WBCS, what are the sectors of economy? Sometimes it will be asked, what are the types of economy? So Mone Raghavan, Duta Jinis Alada. Okay, sectors of economy. Primary sector. What is called primary sector? All activities where there is a direct use of natural resources such as agriculture, forestry, fishing, fuels, metals, minerals. You can say that sometimes mining is also considered as primary activity, where there is a direct use of natural resources. I will give you an example. Okay, now suppose we are working in a biscuit manufacturing company. Now the biscuit can be manufactured only by wheat or paddy. So we can say that a paddy is cultivated by agriculture and allied primary sector in India, and so that these sector are also called as agriculture and allied are the primary sector in India. So in it is basically, you can say, the country where the primary sector dominates is underdeveloped country. Okay, now come to the secondary sector. Whatever we produced in the first part, that is the primary sector, if you will manufacture anything from that, then it is called as secondary sector, or manufacturing of anything using raw material of primary sector. I told na, to manufacture a biscuit we need paddy, we cultivate paddy in primary sector. Now we will manufacture the biscuit in industry, the industrial sector also. That is why it is also called as industrial sector, that is biscuit, cake, and those countries which are dominate, that those countries where secondary sector dominates are called developing countries. Okay, now come to the tertiary sector. Tertiary sector are the services provided like education, banking, insurance, transportation, tourism, etc. In those countries where this sector dominates, they are the developed countries. And suppose we have manufactured the biscuit, we have to do service, we have to do transportation, we have to do economic transaction. So those parts are called that the tertiary sector. Okay, now what are the types of economy? On the basis of this, there are agrarian economy, there are industrial economy, there are service economy. The agrarian economy, where primary sector contributes more than 50% of the GDP, is called as agrarian economy. So on monetary term, India is not, because we can see India service sector contribute more than 50%, but on dependency ratio make it so, because we can see the 50% and more than 50% of the population of the country depends upon agrarian sector and agricultural and allied activities. We can see that this sector contributes 60% of the GDP, but it gives employment to 49% of the country. Now we can see that those sectors are contributing 60%, having employment of 49%, they are naturally very poor. That is the little bit of, you can say, the stress of our farmers. Now come to the industrial economy, that is where the secondary sectors contribute more than 50% of the GDP. Okay, Europe in 20th century was industrial economy. Even you can say the France, Britain, USA, they have developed, they have passed this stage. They earlier they were industrials, you can say economy, but right now they become, you can say, service economy. After saturation, when there is no more, you can say, possibility of increase their, you can say, sales, then they move to service economy. In India, it contributes 24% of the GDP and it provides employment to 24% of the people. Okay, now what is service economy, where the tertiary sector contribute more than 50% of the GDP? Tertiary sector also provide maximum employment in service economies. India, there is a classical example, GDP, it contributes 49-51% of the GDP, but employment is 27%. So what is the problem with India? Monetary terms, we are tertiary or service economy, but literally we are an agrarian economy. Okay, now let's move. What is GDP, GNP, NNP, national income? It is very easy, but I feel that the students are facing a lot of problem. First of all, suppose you want to prepare anything, you want to manufacture anything. আপনি কিছু তৈরি করতে চান, আপনি কোনো ইন্ডাস্ট্রি করতে চান, তাহলে কত টাকা লাগবে, কত আমাদের, হোয়াট ইজ দ্য কস্ট অফ দ্য প্রোডাকশন? ওকে, নাও দ্যাট ইজ কল্ড দ্য ফ্যাক্টর কস্ট, মিনস হোয়াট আর দ্য টোটাল কস্ট ইজ কল্ড ফ্যাক্টর কস্ট। ফার্স্ট অফ অল উই হ্যাভ টু পারচেজ এ প্যাচ অফ ল্যান্ড, ওকে, ফর ল্যান্ড উই হ্যাভ টু গিভ রেন্ট, অন ল্যান্ড উই উইল পুট আওয়ার ক্যাপিটাল, ওকে, দ্যাট হোয়াট এভার দ্য ইনভেস্টমেন্ট ইজ নিডেড, ফর দ্যাট উই উইল টেক আ লোন ফ্রম গভর্নমেন্ট অ্যান্ড উই উইল পে ইন্টারেস্ট, ওকে। Now we have to bring labor also, those who will work, and we have to give them wage. Apart from that, I have to invest, I have invested my time, that this is called entrepreneurship. Then what I will get? Profit. This is the total cost, that is also called as a factor cost. Suppose a pen, after adding all the four components, cost 10 rupees. Now the 10 rupees is a factor cost, but can I get the pen in 10 rupees? No, because we are living in a country, so we have to pay some taxes also. So the cost of the pen, earlier it was the factor cost was 10 rupees and the government took a tax of 2 rupees, the cost of the pen becomes 12 rupees. Suppose we are new in the industry, and in fertilizer industry and many more industry, government provides subsidies also. So if we will include the price of the subsidy, then suppose government is giving 50 paisa subsidy, then the cost of the pen becomes 11 rupees 50 paisa. So the market cost become 11 rupees 50 paisa, but the factor cost was 10 rupees. Okay, now so what is market cost? Market cost equal to factor cost plus taxes minus subsidies. Why I am telling this? Later you will know. Now we come to the GDP, GNP, NDP, net national product. What is GDP? Gross domestic product. Domestic money, whatever is produced in the geographical country of the country. Good and service produced within the geographical boundary of the country. And if in India some foreigners are working, then they will be also calculated on the GDP. Okay, what is the net? Domestic product will remain the same, and gross, here it is net, means earlier it was gross, it means net, nothing. The GDP minus depreciation, মানে আমি একটা গাড়ি নিয়েছি গত বছর, ধরো ওর দাম ছিল 1 লক্ষ টাকা, তাহলে এক বছরের মধ্যে কিছু তো ডেপ্রিসিয়েট করবো, সাপোজ দ্য রেট অফ ডেপ্রিসিয়েশন ইজ 20%. So this year, again in the calculation of GDP, it will be 80,000 rupees because 20% depreciated. So in the net, whatever be the thing, if it will come net, then minus that thing, minus depreciation, that is net domestic product equal to GDP minus depreciation. আবার এখানে domestic ছিল, এখানে national এসে গেল, GNP, gross national product. এখানে কিছু করতে হবে না, আগে যে জিওগ্রাফিক্যাল বাউন্ডারি, যে ডোমেস্টিক প্রোডাক্ট ছিল, সেটা হয়ে যাবে ন্যাশনালিস্ট, হোয়াট এভার ইজ প্রোডিউসড বাই ইন্ডিয়ান উইল কাম ইন টু জিডিপি। মনে রাখবেন, অনেকটা ইন্ডিয়ান আছে যে মানে গালফে চাকরি করছে, আমেরিকাতে চাকরি করছে, ইউরোপে চাকরি করছে, অনেকটা ইউরোপিয়ান আছে যে ইন্ডিয়াতে চাকরি করছে, মানে গুড অ্যান্ড সার্ভিস প্রোডিউস উইদিন দ্য জিওগ্রাফিক্যাল বাউন্ডারি প্লাস নেট ইনকাম রিসিভ ফ্রম অ্যাব্রড, রেমিটেন্সেস, লোন অ্যান্ড এক্সটার্নাল গ্রান্টস। রেমিটেন্সেস মানে দু রকম রেমিটেন্স হয়, একটা যে ভারতীয় বাইরে থেকে আমার দেশে পাঠাবে, আর অনেকটা বাইরে লোক বা ফরেনার আমার থেকে বাইরে পাঠাবে, তো সেটাই, দ্যাট ইজ জিডিপি প্লাস নেট ইনকাম রিসিভ ফ্রম অ্যাব্রোড। ইট মে বি রেমিটান্সেস, ইট মে বি লোনস, ইট মে বি এক্সটার্নাল গ্রান্ট। রিমেম্বার ওয়ান থিং, হোয়াট এভার ইজ দ্য ডান বাই ইন্ডিয়ান্স ইজ জিএনপি। ওকে, now what is net? Again, if the gross is removed by net, then whatever was GNP just minus depreciation, nothing else. Why I am telling you this? It is very easy to remember. Gross means whatever produced, okay, domestic means produced in the country. If the gross net will replace the gross, then just minus depreciation. If the domestic will replace national, just earlier it was in the geographical boundary of India, now it was by Indian only. And if the net replace, again GNP minus depreciation. Okay, now what is national income? National income at factor cost equal to national income at market cost minus indirect taxes. Chilo to, tokhon market cost equal to ki chilo? Market cost equal to chilo factor cost plus taxes. সেই জন্য ফ্যাক্টর কস্ট ইকুয়াল টু মার্কেট কস্ট মাইনাস ইনডাইরেক্ট ট্যাক্সেস। আর ন্যাশনাল ইনকাম অ্যাট ফ্যাক্টর কস্ট আগেন সাবসিডিজও ছিল, তো এনএনপি এট মার্কেট কস্ট প্লাস সাবসিডিজ, এই দুটাকে যদি আমি যোগ করে দিব পুটিং ইনডাইরেক্ট ট্যাক্সেস অ্যান্ড সার্ভিস টুগেদার, ন্যাশনাল ইনকাম অ্যাট ফ্যাক্টর কস্ট ইকুয়াল টু ন্যাশনাল ইনকাম অ্যাট মার্কেট কস্ট প্লাস সাবসিডিজ মাইনাস ইনডাইরেক্ট ট্যাক্সেস। উই আর মেজারিং আওয়ার ন্যাশনাল ইনকাম অন দ্য বেসিস অফ ফ্যাক্টর কস্ট, নট মার্কেট কস্ট। রিজন ইজ ইনফ্লেশন। Okay, there are different taxes. Now it is GST. Earlier there were different taxes. So a thing which is produced in 10 rupees may be charged 20 rupees in Karnataka and 12 rupees in Gujarat. But the cost of production, that is the factor cost, will always remain 10. Okay, sometimes the price got increased because of inflation. Okay, so to measure these difficulties, to ignore these difficulties, we measure our national income at factor cost, not at market cost. But in US and other developed countries, they measure national income at market cost. So what is per capita income? Per capita income is national income. National income is national income at factor cost, that is NNP at market cost plus subsidy minus direct tax, minus direct tax. So NNP at factor cost divided by the population comes the per capita income. Okay, now tell me, how was the video? Do share and promote, give your opinion in comment box. I am very thankful that you have given a chance to serve you. Do join WBCS for all, subscribe the channel. Thank you very much.